in and has some shape on it.
Yeah, that would be nice.
And then continues outside to true up with the outside plane of the new glazing surface.
Right.
That'd be ideal. I must say that all the really, all the composite panels with like polystyrene and aluminum front and back that were really consistent, stiff, homogeneous. They most, from what I was seeing, there was some panel thickness choice, but it wasn't variable in form. It was a panel. They could go in, you could get a nice 3/4 panel, but then we would have to find a way to adhere thicker insulation.
Could we use two of those with the insulation in between it?
Maybe you could make two of them with something in between. I guess that would be an adhesive type.
That was the next idea that I had, that whatever we do on the outside surface, there's the thermal break. The insulation doesn't need the thermal break, but it will condensate if it's too cold. And so we then need enough insulation on the inside and past the surface that we put on it to something that can handle a little moisture.
Yeah. I think, but some of these places gave you a choice of the interior surface that make it out of fire, you know, make it out of cement board, then make it out of aluminum, then make it out of sheetrock, then make it out of carbon.
By the way, this is a return. I put it up there instead of down here because the problem in the summer here, the heat goes up and on top gets quite hot.
Yeah.
And I felt that the return would be better up here.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Well,
what's this material here? This black stuff.
Oh, I wouldn't. Mm-mm. Joseph, careful.
Put your hand out and feel it.
I got that from medicine. That was, we bought a lot of that stuff. Perforated.